Welcome back, you guys. In today's video, we're going to be doing a little bit of a catch and cook off. It's just kind of like a little challenge between me and my pop. In my last video, you guys saw me, I was able to bring in 2 keeper speckled trout. So we decided that we would make a little challenge out of that, make things interesting. And this is that video. So this is a little bit of a long one. My cook took a while, had a lot of steps. So I went ahead and put some cards down below so you guys could easily skip to what you do want to see and skip over what you don't want to see. Anyways, without anything else to say, let's go ahead and jump in.
All right, y'all, to start things off, we're going to be making some homemade English muffins. So to do that, we're gonna take 2 cups of whole milk. You can't really compromise on that. It can't not be 2%, cannot be skim milk. It has to be whole milk, and you need to heat it up to anywhere between 100 and like 95 degrees. I usually would say just eyeball it, but you can't really do that. So you kinda have to get a thermometer and make sure that your milk is in between those two. If it's any bit over the 100 degree mark, it will kill your yeast. And if it's under 95s, it won't activate your yeast. So this kind of has to be like perfect. You really have to baby this yeast, but 1 whole pack of dry yeast into there. You can get this stuff at any little supermarket. They've got it at Kroger's, Walmart. You want to make sure you get it all out there. I can hear a little bit of yeast still sneaking around in there. And then also add a little bit of white sugar into that as well. Give this a stir, and this is just gonna get your yeast activated. You wanna let this sit for about 10 minutes, as you can see. While we're waiting for our yeast over there to get nice and frothed up, we're gonna go ahead and take a bowl, put some bread flour in there, and then also add in some fine sea salt. You don't have to use sea salt, but whatever you use, make sure it's like nice and fine. You don't want that coarse salt. It has to be this nice, fine stuff right here. Now that our yeast has had some time to activate and froth up like this, we're gonna go ahead and add it into our flour and sea salt mixture along with 1 whole egg. And you just kinda wanna knead this all together and get it all nice and mixed in well. You can use a stand mixer. I've actually, this is my second try doing this, because the first go around, I was using the stand mixer and it just kind of overworked the dough and never really fully incorporated it. So I don't know, maybe I just stuck at the stand mixer, but I find it a lot easier just to get in there with your hands and make sure everything goes perfectly by the touch. When the dough is all nice and incorporated, you wanna go ahead and take a half a stick of butter. You kind of want this to be like softened butter. The longer it sits outside of the fridge, the better it's gonna be and easier it's gonna be to incorporate into your dough. You can use cold butter, but you run the risk of like overworking your dough trying to get this butter worked into it. So just let it sit out for a little bit, let it soften up, and you'll have a lot easier time. Once you notice all the little cubes of butter in your dough have kind of melted and mixed in with the dough itself, you can go ahead and stop kneading and take a little bit of flour, lightly flour a work surface, whether that's your counter. I just cleaned off this counter, so I'm gonna go ahead and use this, or you could also use like a cutting board, whatever works for you. But counter is probably the easiest way to go. You just wanna lightly flour that. And right here, you're just gonna give it a couple of slap and folds, kind of like kneading, but a little less intensive than kneading. After folding the dough out for a little bit, you wanna go ahead and take a nicely greased bowl. I just took a little bit of butter and rubbed it around the bottom. You're gonna take your dough. And you're just gonna flop that in there. And we're gonna go ahead and cover this. You can use plastic wrap or a damp paper or paper towel, a damp kitchen towel, and just let this sit at room temperature for about an hour. It's gonna give the dough some time to rise and really let that yeast do its thing. All right, y'all, the dough has been resting for about an hour now, and it is ready to be messed with. We're gonna go ahead and dust the top of this with a little bit of flour. There we go. Then throw the rest of that on our workspace. You kind of just want to smack this thing until it deflates just a little bit here. Pull it out. Now what we're going to do is take our dough and split this into 15 different little sections, like little dough balls. Imagine you're making little buns. To form your little ball, all you're going to want to do is take and fold in the seams like this, all around. Now that you have that, slap it on your work surface and just kind of cup it and spin it like this. And then boom, there you go. You got your little ball. Set that over on a pan and let it rest with some cornmeal. You can use cornmeal or flour. Traditionally, you use cornmeal, so that's what I'm using. All right, so I rolled as many as I could. We still got a little bit over here, but we ran out of room on our pan. So before we can continue rolling out some more, we're gonna go ahead and cover these up. Now, ideally you wanna cover them completely, like right here with this little setup that I've got. There's some cracks in here. It's been 10 minutes and these bad boys have been rising. They are ready and it is now time to get to cooking. So while these were rising, I went ahead and started heating up my cast iron skillet. So it's super freaking hot right now. And our only last thing that we got to do is put a little bit of cornmeal on the top of these guys. Just dust them off a little bit with cornmeal. And then actually, that's not the last thing. You also got to smash them down into little English muffin shape pucks like this. So get a nice little 4 to 3 inch puck. And we're going to go ahead and slap that right on the skillet. Do the same thing. You can do them like 3 at a time depending on the size of your skillet here. Mine's perfect for 3 at a time, so that's what we're gonna do. Actually, low key, I might be able to fit 4 on there. We'll see what happens. Now we got the skillet nice and filled up with English muffins. We're gonna let them cook for like 3 to 5 minutes on each side. You want this really hot. I had it on 7 for a bit and I cranked it down to in between like 5 and 6, so medium high heat. And that's not even gonna finish them off. So we're gonna cook these 3 to 5 minutes on each side and then finish them for like 8 minutes in a 350 degree oven. I'll be honest, these have been going for a little bit now and they are smelling kind of burnt. Yeah, they're burnt. So we're gonna turn down the heat a little bit here just because, oh God, no, that is not what we want. We don't want that. So first batch of English muffins are not gonna be too grand. And those were barely on there for like 3 minutes. So 3 to 5 minutes, that is way too hot. We went ahead, turned down the heat to about 5. All right, and we'll just kind of keep a mental timer. Let's see, how are you looking? That's good. Oh yeah, that's good. What's this bad boy looking like? Perfect. Perfect, 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 boys. So, started off rough. They had us in the first half, but now our English muffins are coming out great. Can't wait to see what these ones look like. Let's go ahead and get 2 more on that pan. Take a quick check on these. Went in the first. Perfect, dude, yes. Who needs a timer, bro, honestly? Next one we'll flip is this one, which is notorious for being burnt. Let's see what she looked like. Perfect, dude. There we go, finally. These are gonna be the best of the English muffins. And honestly, I'm not really too sure how many of these are gonna get eaten tonight. So these last 4 right here that are the creme de la creme are probably gonna be the ones that make the plate. Get these bad boys off. Oh my God, y'all. This right here, this front row, this is the primo roll. Row. Let's look. Awesome, beautiful. Let's see, come on, last one. Perfect, boys. Perfect English muffins, guys, holy crap. I'm honestly proud of these ones. These 4 right here, I would show those to Gordon Ramsay. Anyways, we're gonna finish these bad boys off in the oven for like 8 minutes at 350 degrees. So let's pop that in there. And I wish I could say that the hardest part is over, but it's not. We still gotta make the Hollandaise sauce, which is very easy to mess up. I've messed it up a number of times trying to make it in the past, practicing for this episode, so. Hopefully we can pull it off on the first try. All right, making the Hollandaise sauce is pretty simple on paper. All you really need is some egg yolks, a load of butter, lemon juice, sugar, salt, and water. But it's very, 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 very delicate process. So I'm setting up a double boiler right now. We're gonna let this water start simmering. We've got this up above and we just kind of want to lightly kiss the bowl with the steam and very lightly heat up our egg yolks. If the heat is too high, then we're gonna curdle our egg and kind of turn the sauce into like a weird mushy egg paste. Absolutely not what we want. We want this to be like a nice creamy sauce. So start off, take your 4 egg yolks. Get out of there, man. No, dude, this is not how it's supposed to go. This is not how things are supposed to be. Get out of there. Good God, man. please. Don't be over before it starts. All right, so we get these egg yolks going, and we just kind of want these over the heat, and we're gonna mix them until they turn like a little bit of a brighter yellow. Just about 30 seconds. All right, boom. So we take this off the heat now, and we're gonna go ahead and add, I think that's our sugar. God, I hope that's the sugar. A pinch of salt, right? You wanna add all the sugar and just a slight pinch of salt. Too much salt will ruin this. Our lime juice and our water. Tiny bits here. Add this back onto this and we give it our whisk. Now with all of that added, it is time to slowly start adding in our butter. So a little bit at a time, we wanna add in and incorporate our butter, making sure that before we add the next batch, this completely emulsifies. Now, the key here is to try and constantly keep this being whisked. If you stop whisking, you can really mess up the process of emulsification. And that's a big no-no. You don't want that to happen or it's gonna ruin your sauce. So trying to kind of like very quickly dump these in and continue whisking without taking breaks. Like, honestly, I feel like even that little break that I took, this is just too long. So go ahead and do this until we've completely emptied out this thing of butter. All right, fellas, with all the butter added, this right here is our completed sauce. So let's do a drizz check. Oh no, is it drizzly enough? Gosh, dude, it seems to be a bit watery. Feels thick enough though. From the last times I've done this, it feels nice and thick enough, but the issue here is gonna be keeping this warm. So obviously my fish and my poached egg are not ready. So I'm gonna give this a quick taste with a butter knife. Oh yeah, oh dude, look at this. The thickness of it when it falls off of the knife. That's the consistency we're going for. I was worried with the whisk, but Boys, we've done it. This is a perfect Hollandaise sauce. Oh man, sometimes I really impress myself. This is one of those times. So we're gonna go ahead and throw this into like a Yeti cup and cover it with tin foil to keep it nice and warm until we're ready to serve. All right, y'all, so the next step for our Trout Eggs Benedict is gonna be a poached egg. All right, now watch this. This is the technique here. You spin your water around to create a little vortex in the middle of your pot. Boom, so you can see we got the vortex going. Now we wanna drop our egg right in the middle there. Voila, look at it. It's all coming together now. 3 minutes are up, and I'll be honest, this poached egg could be better. It is very like, kind of wispy. It got the right shape that I wanted, but I don't know, the egg yolk just kind of seems all over the place. It actually, or the egg yolk, the egg white seems all over the place. It actually really isn't the shape that I wanted. So this is a fail, if you ask me, when it comes to poached egg. I mean, it's still edible, right? It just doesn't have that, wow, look at that poached egg look to it. So we got our water back up to heat now, and I'm starting to think maybe I lowered it too low. So I'm gonna see how low can I go to stop those bubbles. All right, that's still bubbling. 210, no bubbles. 220. 230, no bubble. Okay, 230, we're starting to get those bubbles. I think 230 is like the Goldilocks zone of, maybe not, 220. So we'll leave it at 220. Give it the nice swirl that we were talking about earlier. Really want to get that vortex in the middle because that's what helps to take those wild bits that are all over the place and kind of center it like a centrifuge. And boom, that looks good. Please. Okay. I'm hoping that this one is at the right temp to where it still cooks properly, but it has the right shape that I want. That looks nice. Let's just see, is it gonna cook all the way through? While we're waiting on that other egg to finish poaching up, I'm gonna go ahead and prepare my trout fillets. So, as you guys know, we are doing the cook-off. My dad has two fillets, I have two fillets. And I just wanna get these nice and portioned up to where they fit perfectly on my egg McMuffins, God, what am I saying? On my English muffins. So I'm thinking half is gonna be a little too much, but if I cut these into thirds, if I cut each fillet into like thirds, that would be the perfect size just to set right on the English muffin, have a poached egg on top, drizzle the hollandaise, and that's just gonna look, it's gonna look and taste, hopefully taste, delicious. I'll be honest, when I was thinking of this recipe in my head, I was kind of trolling, like I was just messing around thinking to myself, you know, what sounds funny and crazy, like a clickbaity title, and I was thinking to myself, trout and eggs. And then after talking to my family about it, talking to my dad, they were all like, no, that sounds horrible. And I had to think to myself, like, yeah, honestly, it does sound horrible, but how can we make it taste good? So after a long thought process, I figured, Eggs Benedict, everybody likes that, right? Just throw some trout in there instead of the Canadian bacon. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna fry these all up in salt and pepper and butter. That's gonna be it. I don't want any clashing flavors with the seasoning. I just want a very neutral, slightly seasoned taste to go with the Eggs Benedict. 3 minutes are up for our second poached egg, and I can already see that this one is looking a whole lot better. Oh my goodness, guys, look at the difference. That's night and day. Dude, this one's going on Instagram. I swear, this is the egg going on Instagram right here. Holy crap. Look at that. I don't even want to touch it. That right there is a perfectly poached egg. My God, man. Like, look at this. Look at this. This is like expectation, or wait. Expectation, reality. Except this is real. It's here. I did it. Holy crap. While those last couple eggs are poaching up, I'm going to go ahead and season these little bits of trout here. So salt. Like I said, very simple here. Very, very simple. We're doing salt and pepper. And I thought about doing white pepper, but I was like, you know what? I honestly don't know. I don't know if white pepper and black pepper have the same taste. And I don't want to do anything crazy. I don't want to mess anything up. So we're going with black pepper because that's what I know. But we got our filet seasoned. Now we get the mini skillet nice and hot. All right, y'all. So my dad has just started to come in here and start cooking for his dish. As you know, we're doing the challenge here. See whose dish is better. I mean, I think mine's gonna be better. Everything's homemade, everything's delicious. It should, on paper, it should be great. So right now, I wasn't talking because my dad was doing his intro, but we're toasting up our English muffins and we're gonna let those get a little bit toasty and get ready to plate. Butter in the pan, let that start to sizzle.
Is the butter out here?
Not all of it, no. Pan's getting nice and hot. Let's get two choice fillets here. These will be the ones. We're gonna let those cook. Let those finish up for like 30 seconds. And we're ready to plate, boys. My God, look at this. This looks great. These look great. This is gonna be great. That's all I have to say. All right, we're done, guys. Time to plate. So take a fillet of speckled trout, place it centered on one of our English muffins here. Guys, I'm seriously freaking out. Like, this is all coming together so perfectly. I've literally been working on this for like the past 4, maybe 5 hours now since the start of making this English muffin dough. So we're gonna get our eggs and put those on top. Next, we have our hollandaise sauce. Still nice and warm in here. Oh, baby. Yes, it's nice and thick. I'm gonna drizzle this on top there. Oh my God, boys. There's one last final touch that you have to do.
How much lime? Half a lime juice.
Perfect, guys. Just a little bit of smoked paprika on the top, just to add some flair. All right, everyone, I gotta get some B-roll of this before we dig in here. The moment of truth. I'm gonna go ahead and try one of these. My dad.
You have to get Mama or Elijah to try it.
Well, they can try the other one, but I'm gonna take first bite here.
Cause you're gonna like rate your own as a 10 or something.
Dad, come on, look at this. Look at this thing. It is most definitely a 10. All right, so As you heard, we need an official taste tester here, but look at that. This looks delicious. Let's go ahead and cut her. Right down the middle there. I'll be honest, I'm a little worried about the texture of fish with my egg and my English muffin, but I'm gonna give it a go, so let's go ahead down the hatch.
Okay.
Oh my god. Seriously, I'm holding back tears. It is so good.
All right, fellas, so we've got an official taste tester here. It's my mom. My brother didn't want to eat it. He's not into seafood, but I already know it's going to be a good review.
I'm not really into seafood either, but we'll see.
This is more than seafood.
Shannon is now attempting to eat Christian's mouth creation.
Dang it.
That just does not look good.
This is French cuisine. I was holding back tears.
Whatever.
I'm not gonna lie, it's really good.
Ew, it's really good. Speckled trout though with
and
egg.
You can't taste the fish at all. Yeah. It's really good. Like,
here we go, y'all.
Dang, that's a big old bite.
You don't taste the speckled trout.
It's beautiful. It's a beautiful
That's
egg.
What I
it
said.
Needs more speckled trout.
It's got a thick piece of speckled trout. It's good.
That's a really good.
Oh god, my camera's like glitching out.
Eggs Benedict. Mm-hmm. It's really good.
Let's try Eggs Benedict.
Okay, let me have
look,
some more.
Look, talking to the camera.
Eggs Benedict with trout. Because there's more Eggs Benedict. There's,
that's
you can't
the, that's
say
the beauty of
Eggs Benedict.
Look, guys,
it doesn't have
when,
enough trout.
When we started whatever. This, when we started
I'm
this
go
video,
back over there and cook.
When we started this video, we said we wanted to make trout and eggs, but make it good. And that's exactly what we did, boys. All right.
You guys it is it. Phenomenal.
But Dad's not making trout and eggs, is he?
No, he's making
I'm about to eat some more of this because it's good.
I just did this as a Daredevil challenge.
Saved a little bit for last. Just move it around.
All right, Phillip, this dish is pretty
voila,
much
done. Bam, done. We just don't have the linguine. Okay, and my dish does not require the use of a... But here we go. Just the way I remembered it. That no, that's really good.
I'm sorry.
I just can't take this seriously.
No, this is really good.
I can't, guys, like, let's be.
This oh, is freaking phenomenal.
Go look at the way I cooked my
here.
Food.
I tried yours, I said yours was good. Don't taint my food. Like, you already put Eggs Benedict in my dish and it doesn't go. Whatever.
Oh, okay.
Elijah's gonna be the true judge.
I think it would be good, right?
I have but to be the judge because Elijah doesn't want to taste it.
It's missing something like
linguine. Yeah,
exactly. It's an incomplete dish.
I didn't have enough time. Christian, look at our kitchen is a disaster. Like a tornado came through here. And is that even recording?
No, I had to turn off the batteries though.
It's a phenomenal dish. Fresh fish. It's the way I remembered it, minus the linguine.
Yours is just the fish, and you can taste the flavors. Like it's delicious. Christian's, you can't really taste the fish. It's just like other flavors. So
you
it's
see,
hard to pick
you can
winner.
Taste my fish. The fish is there, and it tastes delicious.
All right, you guys, look. I wanna say it like this. Imagine you're going to listen to music, right? Classical music, and you see a lonely guy on the street. He's really, really good at playing the violin, right? He's over there. He's playing it. He's playing his violin. And it sounds awesome. It sounds amazing. But then across the street. It's like you hear a beautiful orchestra. There's a cello, there's the violin, the viola, a whole ensemble, and it just, you hear it and it brings tears
oh
to your eyes.
God,
that's,
what?
That's the difference we're working with here, guys. And I just, that's gonna be the end for me. I'm gonna replay the outro. That's all I got to say. Orchestra versus violin.
All right, you guys, so you heard it there. I've got two official taste testers, even my dad. I'm in competition with him, and he even said, it tastes great. It's a really good dish, and we did it. Mission accomplished. We turned trout and eggs, which just sounds so crazy and weird that it shouldn't be good, and we made it really good. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, smack the like button, smack the subscribe button, and I hope you'll have a great rest of y'all's day. Peace.